Today we are going to check out the Realme Buds Q, and these are actually pretty good except for some really odd choices that I don't understand why they went with. Hey guys, I am Siddharth and let's get started. In the box, you get the earbuds in their case with instructions on how to turn them on for the first time. Then you get a micro USB cable, some extra ear tips of different sizes, and finally a manual with warranty card. Realme says that these earphones have been designed by José Lévy from France, who gave it this pebble-like shape, and you can see how incredibly difficult it must have been to come up with this complex masterpiece in design. It does feel pretty nice in hands though, even if the plastics used here still feel kind of cheap, and it still uses a micro USB port. Opening the magnetic lid will take you to the earbuds, which are actually well designed and look better than other budget earbuds. They do have a shape that feels like it is made to be inserted in your ears, and the subtle yellow accents on the ear tips are also a nice addition. The side surface of the Realme Buds Q is touch sensitive plastic, and you can touch it to control the playback of your music. So you can play pause with a double tap, change tracks with a triple tap, and you can actually change the assignments with the Realme Link app, so you can add the functionality for a voice assistant. You can also touch and hold both earbuds to enable game mode, which we will talk about later, but I have to say that this touch functionality is a pretty hit or miss with these earbuds, and about 25-50% of times it just didn't work. I am not sure what the reason for that is, as I did try to precisely touch the touch area, but it still didn't register very well. So I personally would have just preferred buttons instead of this touch functionality that doesn't work properly. Unlike most other earbuds on the market, these don't have LEDs on the earbuds, so you won't know if they are turned on or not, or if they have finished charging in the case or not, and I really don't know why they decided to go with this approach. The case also doesn't clearly indicate what the battery level is, and I am not sure if it blinks red to indicate that the battery is low, because I kept charging it because one of the earbuds wasn't working, and I thought that it was because it wasn't charged. But it was actually charged, and I had to touch and hold it for 5 seconds like you have to do on the first time, and then it was fixed. So it isn't a big issue, but this is the kind of problem you have when you don't see any LEDs blinking on either the case or the earbud. And for a company boasting about how good their design is, I think that this is a really big oversight. The battery life is pretty good on these. The earbuds offer a 4-hour playback time, which was accurate in my test, and the case offers up to 20 hours, which it should deliver, but I wasn't able to verify this as I charged it multiple times as I thought that it was not charged. But the good news is that the frustrations mostly end here, as the comfort on these is pretty good. They do fit well in my ears, and at first I thought that they were going to fall out of my ears because of the way they fit, but that didn't happen and I was able to comfortably wear these for hours. I still had to go with the bigger ear tips for proper sound, which weren't as comfortable, but I think most people should find the medium ear tips to be the best for them. By the way, make sure that you are subscribed to the channel with bell icon, because I also got these new Oppo TWS earphones, and I will be comparing these Realme earbuds with these along with the Redmi Earbuds S in a future video. They also have an IPX4 water resistance rating, which means that they are protected from splashes of water and sweat, but you can't immerse them in water. There is a game mode on these, so when you press and hold both the earbuds, you hear a cheesy sound of a car engine starting, and that is the game mode. It does make it better for watching videos, as the videos get more in sync with audio, and while it also does somewhat reduce the sound delay while gaming, there still is a significant delay, so it is definitely not going to be as good as wired earphones. But for games like PUBG, I don't mind the slight delay in gunshots. This is what the microphone sounds like, and it is not bad, but it is not that great either. In my Redmi Earbuds S review, you can see that the microphone on those does sound a little better, but this isn't bad either, and I didn't have any problems during calls. Finally, coming to the sound quality, it is also a complicated matter. The good news is that they can sound really good, but the not so good news is that you will have to use equalizer to get that good sound. So I am going to talk about how they sound without using equalizer first, and then I will explain why using equalizer is necessary. So the bass on these is good for the price. It is boosted and it is punchy, but it is done in a nice way, so it doesn't sound muddy. The mids on these are also not bad, but the vocals don't sound great because of how the highs are tuned. The highs on these are what I found to be too accentuated, and that keeps them from achieving the cohesion that would have given them an overall great sound. The upper mid-range of vocals and some parts of treble are boosted too much, so vocals don't sound natural, and then the treble is also not very pleasant to listen to for long periods, and it just sounds quite harsh. But thankfully, most of this can be solved easily with an equalizer, and you can use these settings to tame the treble down, and then it sounds pretty good. Generally, I use equalizer to enhance the sound of audio gear, but with these earphones, I feel that it is kind of necessary. The soundstage on these is pretty good though, which does make the music fun to listen to. So overall, I do think that for the 2000 rupees price point, the Realme Buds Q do offer good sound quality, and they could be the best choice in this segment. The design is actually good, and the battery life is also great, but the lack of proper indication of battery levels and a lack of controls that work properly are some drawbacks that keep it from achieving the class-leading magic. But if you are strictly limited to 2000 rupees range, I think that you won't be disappointed with these, as they do deliver on the essentials and they don't sound like cheap earphones. And if you use equalizer, they can sound really good. So that was it for this video. I'll have links to buy these in the video description. Let me know what you think about these in the comment section below, and give this video a thumbs up if you liked it or a thumbs down if you disliked it. Subscribe with bell. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.